Hello, my name is Korat Tuberkibir and I am the owner and founder of Holistic SEO and Digital. In this video, I will demonstrate one of the SEO case studies and also an SEO success story. Of course, an SEO case study and SEO success story are not the same thing, and a failure of SEO can be processed with an SEO case study too, because main topic of an SEO case study is the process of analyzing the search engine and its decision trees or its algorithmic hierarchy. In this context, this video won't be so long. I will try to explain a couple of things here, and probably I will hide the name of the project in this video, and I will explain what was the name of the domain in the case study publication. There will be a couple of more videos like this. I will demonstrate also other projects, and most of these projects will be explained and they will be opened within the case study article. This project has been started 5 months ago, and at the moment we have 5,000 clicks per day, and we have a jump here. So let me a little bit explain how you can understand what these jumps are. Topical authority and topical coverage are connected to each other. I have already given a kind of simple or simplified formula for it. But also there are a little bit more terms here that can help you to understand what these things are actually, like categorical quality and related search activity, possible search activity, and search intent coverage. To do that, or to understand all of these terms and to use all of these terms within your topical map, you will also need to know what is query processing. You will need to be able to understand the properties or attributes of an entity and their connections, and how a search engine can think that, okay, this web page actually includes lots of information and also facts, accurate facts about that. To create this type of successes, you will also need to know what a query template, what a document template, and how you can use this query and document templates to become an authority. In this project, I have used document templates, query templates, and root attributes. I have also created lots of root pages, seed pages, and node pages. These terms also will be explained within my semantic SEO course. And this presentation is open to you at the moment. If you want to know more things about semantic search engines and understanding the query, please check what these things are in the semantic SEO course. There will be a full extended video for this presentation, and also probably this presentation has been presented in 2021 SEO Rush for the Polish SEOs in a VIP event. Probably I will publish that video for free, so I believe you will be able to understand more things there. But in the course there will be an extended version, because in the live version I didn't have so much time to process all these things. You see the information here and you can check it. So when it comes to semantic SEO, you should be patient. To be honest, 5 months is not so long history to create a kind of long time for an SEO success. But when it comes to the semantic SEO, sometimes your clients think that, okay, we are losing a little bit ranking, but actually it doesn't matter. If you want to know the decision tree of the search engine here, there are two fundamental terms. One is the initial ranking, the other one is the re-ranking. And there is also another thing that I call frequency of publication, or we can call it like momentum. And if the momentum of the source is high, your source will be perceived as active, not a static source. Your content won't be perceived as stale or old or outdated. So if you refresh your source, it means that you are more active than your competitors. And if you lose your momentum, you can experience a kind of ranking loss. We also experienced this in this project, because my client is in the fitness industry and they had a couple of problems there, and we couldn't find sometimes the proper investment options here or the funds. But eventually we were able to protect the momentum there. That's why I told the client that you should increase the momentum step by step. And for hard times, you should have a kind of backup article so that actually you can protect your activeness while publishing new content. This is important for creating a crawl frequency and crawl pattern. And it's also important to decrease the indexing delays. Or the indexing delays are a little bit rare term. You publish an article here and there is a first hit from the Googlebot. If the first hit is like in 10 seconds, for instance, whenever you publish a content, if they realize it, it means that actually they care about you. We already know that search engine even don't put all the sites into one server or one data center. If your site is high quality, they will use tier one servers for your website, and the tier one servers are the best servers for serving. So it means that search engine categorizes all of the web, not just for information level, but also for quality level. And I know that you don't like this segment a lot, but it goes like that. And this is the CTR section, and this is the average position section. Let me show it to you from also Ahrefs. Ahrefs, to be honest, isn't aware of the actual traffic that we get. We are getting 5 times more of this, but it's just here, as you can see. And this is from SEMrush. SEMrush shows a better result here, or more accurate, but still we are getting more than 2 times of this number at the moment, and it will be higher. The jump here, this jump, this shows a search engine algorithm update. As you can see, you can also check the date, and you can check the updates here too. I have this kind of a shortcut. I believe it will be useful for you too. And this is a representation of the re-ranking process. If you see this kind of jump, it means that your categorical quality has been perceived and you have enough impression from the related words. These related words, when they are together within a co-occurrence matrices, it means that these are related to each other and the source has impression for all of these terms within the same co-occurrence matrix. And once you have enough impression, it means that your categorical quality is good enough to make a jump for further. And then you will see a kind of decrease, because this is the beginning of the re-ranking, and after that search engine will try to adjust your new rankings based on the prominence of the source and based on, of course, your end topical authority. And in the future videos, I will demonstrate more results like this. This is the process from the analytics. As you can see, it's like that, and there is a jump here. And most of the traffic is from organic, like 95%, and some of them are from different sections. And let me just continue a little bit with other sections. So the first question that you have here, I believe, how many content I publish here? It's too lot. I can't have too much content we have published in 5 months. But I can tell you that 8% of this content wasn't for getting actual traffic, because most of this content are about non-popular topics. That's why I tell you that I don't care about the search volume or search demand. I care about the information and coverage on a topic. If you cover a topic in a well comprehensive and in a good way, it means that the other popular sections will be supported. All the relevant sections, all the relevant pages will support each other. That's why in my topical authority case study with OnCrow, and also in the long version, which is in Holistic SEO Digital, Holistic SEO that digital website, you will see a term there, neighborhood content. If a neighborhood content is bad, it means that other one will be bad too. And if you want to see which content is bad, do not just check the clicks, because a topic might not be popular, and it doesn't mean that the content on that unpopular topic will be unquality also. You can write about small countries, you can write about small and not so important attributes of small countries. It means that there will be no so much impressions from there, and there will be no so much clicks from there. But if you process one of these small countries in a really, really good way, the important countries, the big ones, they will be supported from your source, because search engine will think that, okay, for this type of an entity, this source is good enough. It means that actually it can be good for another country too. And to do that, you will need to cover more things. There is something that I call central entity and also source context. My source context here is Visa application, and there are more things there that I will explain within the course, of course. But when I say course, I mean the semantic SEO course. And in my previous video, I have told you that if you have more questions, please add all of these questions there, and I will explain all the things there. And I will take all of your questions. I will probably use these questions within the course. If the question is unique and really, really nice, if it makes me to explore new and unique things, you will be counted as a contributor, and that will be a huge discount for you. And besides all of this, I believe I covered lots of things. In the future videos, maybe I can show the coverage sections and other things. And before the finishing, let me just show a couple of more things here. Let's compare the traffic a little bit here, so you can understand the growth here a little further. This is a compare of the last 6 months, And this is a compare for the last 3 months. And this is a compare for the last 28 days. Sorry, okay, year or year. Okay, I have chosen the wrong one, sorry. And this is for the last 4 week comparison. If you compare it like here, let's compare it. First, let's choose April. April is the second month in this project. And then let's choose July. We can also choose August since we have more traffic there. This is like that. And it will be very, very, very much better, to be honest. In topical authority, you will see more ranking situations, and you will see more and better initial rankings. If you have a categorical quality and topical authority, it means that every new written and new published content will be indexed faster, and they will be ranked better because all of the other sections will support it. And the logic of the initial ranking and re-ranking are based on topical coverage in the context of entity connections or attributes of these entities. So if you have a better initial ranking score, it means that your re-ranking will happen soon, and it will also increase your traffic in a better way. In this context, I will again choose for the last 6 months, and it goes like that, and you will see more jumps like this or more quick increases like this. As you can see, there is also a kind of stale area, and in this area it doesn't mean that we did something wrong. It means that actually search engine didn't need to create a kind of re-ranking process for this topic in Turkey. But whenever you see a kind of re-ranking process, it means that you will be crawled more, and your crawl budget, crawl demand based on that also, and your ranking capacity or prominence score for that specific topic or knowledge domain will be increased, and everything will continue to improve and improve. Let me just demonstrate a little bit the case study articles and their beginning. And these are two different articles. In this one, there will be two different websites. For these ones are related to semantic SEO and technical SEO. And in this one, I will have more and more terms that we will need to process and more website examples. In the future videos, I will demonstrate more websites in the context of semantics and technical SEO. I believe then I will be able to demonstrate some of the sections here. And some of you have already stopped the video, and I believe you check the words here. If you know of Tristan Upstill, I don't know how to pronounce his name, to be honest, because I have seen his name from the Google patents and his book and researches. But this is one of the favorite quotes for me in the search engine area. I believe you will like it. And that's it, okay? In the future videos, we will see each other a lot, I guess. Thank you.